Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to peek around my shoulder. I mean, across, over, whatever. Anyway, I get to play and you get to watch. So this is near Necropolis, and the way things are now is that I took care of some super mutants and then reported to those more militant ghouls and also took care of those. And I'm somewhat tempted to go back even further and leave those things undone because I realized that those super mutants over there prove a very nice shortcut to the main lab or main base, should your need be. But, well, I know where it is anyway, so let's leave it at that. Our next big goal is Glow, but this is where I wanna do some goody exploring as well. Let's see how much of the map is up here. Okay, I'm gonna leave the upper map for laters and go systematic here. Taking quite large sweet days. I remember in one of my games I tried to make three strips across each map tile in the hopes of running into the random occurrences. Got my keyboard controls back. Oh, if by leader they mean monster, then going to the mutant base early. Blowing it up early wouldn't be such a bad idea after all. Okay, I'm gonna let it slip for now. Especially since I'm kind of under-equipped to deal with that kind of fight anyway. Landscape is getting more interesting here. Some punks. Let's see then. might I go? 60, 60. Stand still, dog. Dog. Okay, Vernon. Trying to figure out how many game tiles there were, I mean how many these local maps there were for each main map tile, and I don't think I actually figured it out. It looks more like when you enter local map, then you enter a random piece of landscape. So it's not like one-to-one correspondence there. Are we getting irradiated yet? As if we're moving slower. Okay. Can I do some science here? Thank you. Fallout 2, I was amazed how many caves there were, especially at the map edge. And over there I did the same map sweeping, except I did some of it for the free play, so it didn't affect any of my own outcomes. And these main map edges were very much littered with caves. Ooh. Okay, and we are radiated. Let's see. Elegant indeed. Okay, let's check out the radiation now. So first, okay, apparently not radiated anymore. I know I could have bought one of these Geiger counters from general store, but I somehow remember that that it was possible to loot one over here, so I sort of decided not to buy one on principle. Nope, I don't want to talk to you right now. A loser, huh? This music was used in Big Mountain in New Vegas. This loader doesn't have anything either. Go figure. Are there any more? Okay. Is this another one? Thank you.
passion.
Okay. Can't tell if the Radex is still in effect or what. Okay, if I remember correctly, there was a bunch of traps here. And if I remember correctly, there was also a bunch of stuff to blow up here. Ian's wallet. I think I'm gonna wait for the next dose and then apply some right away. Oh yeah, there was some elevator action here. Where I have to collect the different color key cards or something. Cards that carried rocks, now that's wild. They found a trap. And looks like minimum damage, which means that we have successfully evaded the trap, basically. Traps here. Any dead bodies? Nope. Don't seem so. which required some explosives or something. Okay, now one thing that I miss with the old school Fallout is some exact numerical readings about my radiation levels. Better decide when to deploy the drugs. Shit. Okay, too much damage. Let's see if we can thing is I never quite figured out how to detect traps to check the wall or floor or what. This also where the elevators had some sort of force field or protection or something around them. Receive a gift shortly. That was the deal. If the emergency power is on, then the elevators have force fields around it or something. Okay, this is the explosives part. Ian, that means you too. I should have just run to the next room. I don't know what the heck he's a ghoul really is, but over here, the kissel is kind of gooey. Ah, damn it. Gooey dessert. Okay, let's come back to this one later. Fiddling with the power settings. Okay, so if the emergency power is enabled, then the pots are also online or something like that. Oh yeah, and now I remember the primary power could only... Whoa! Could only be restored from some other terminal or something. Seems that I can't tamper with them either while they're offline. here? Nope. This would be the spot that I usually just plain miss. Try to dynamite. Might work too. Save while I'm not addicted yet. Also, I forgot to check out what the oh, that's the Gregion story. I say we go back up first and try to tackle that door. Too high skill. handful of them to inform me when the timer is ticking. Was this door welded shut this one? Still checking, huh? Okay, let's check this out. Okay, let's get back to that door later. Actually, I'm gonna leave the explosives here. Or at least one of them. Elevator, isn't it? At least here. So let's take it to watch. And this one is unmarked, and the red elevator was, I think, in the other end. Okay, time for a new save. Except that. Stand still. Stand still when you're in a doorway or something, blocking a doorway. I think my crew is generally in quite good health at the moment. awesome here. And again, probably the easiest way to disarm them is just to run through them. Waving arms in the air and shouting something like maybe. It's about time we found some zap grenades. What's the official name? Pulse grenades. Given that there are all those bots around here. I mean, it makes sense to have some countermeasures in case they malfunction or something. Oh dear, I think I wish I had the laser pistol with me. Okay, let's see. Of course, it's a good trade. Of course, you don't respond with equally good trade when we're in a mutant holding cell, for example. Blue one took us to the floor in between. Okay. So let's see. Sure. A sip from my trusty Bolt 13 canteen. Exploding pants for me. doesn't work in this this early either. It's abandoned later. Okay, we are not going to carry that. Just for currency. Oh yeah. Thank you. Exactly. I have some numbers. The numbers tell me to take drugs. Save. That's the main frame, I think. I mean, this thing basically screams science. Why can't I do anything with it? Come on. If there was some self-destruct thing going on here as well or not. Did we go in this room? I don't think so. Just peek behind the corner. There already. I sincerely hope they haven't placed any blockers on this side. have some stuff for you. Remember how the tools and medkits worked here, like if you use them, do you consume them over time or what? Science. augmented growth. Come on, you're describing cancer. I can't remember if I gleaned this information in my earlier game. I don't think I did. Why can't I ask him about the radiation now? Let's try again. Oh, okay, now I get it. So I heard already. Are you telling me there are super mutants on level 5? Here we are not radiated. Oh yeah, we are not. Okay. Now let's see about that chess. I wonder if the results are random or... or the does it depend on my my skill level? Personage names contain some obscure references and inside jokes, which I'm totally missing here. Yep, okay. Chair, of course. Okay, security, research. Right, I think since we're all cozy and non-radiated and safe in this room, it's a good place to take a break, and for me too. And the manual save, of course. Mainframe. Just overwrite this one. So, see you with girls later, and bye bye for now.